Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Holiday World Houston at Katy. My name is Gary, but all my mates call me Croc. I don't know why, but they all do. I'm here to show you the Passport Ultralight Grand Touring Edition 3180. A beautifully constructed trailer, very lightweight, 100% welded aluminum frame with a glass fiber skin. It's got plenty of storage. I'm gonna start off right here. As you can see, this storage bin goes all the way through. And when we show you on the other side, we'll show you that aluminum framing and just how strong it is. Come along, Daisy May. Very aerodynamic front shape here. This is a solid fiberglass piece with a rock guard underneath. Stop all those chips coming up. That can easily damage a trailer. Here we have two gas bottles, nicely aerodynamically hidden in this box here. They have a semi-automatic switchover system on them, so you're never going to run out of gas. You just got to remember, when one's empty, turn it to the other one and get one filled. There's room here for two 12-volt batteries for emergency lighting or for you guys that like to go really off-road. Here we have the cranking handle to put it on the truck or on the car. This can easily be replaced by a powered unit, which is not too expensive. And when you get to my age, pressing a button is much easier than cranking a handle. Let's go around to the side now. Please take note that these storage doors are not those ultra thin things that you see with no insulation. This is a fully insulated door. Here we have proper rubber seals, makes it airtight, watertight. And of course, when you're closed up, it's all part of the insulation package. Insulation is very important on a trailer, especially here in the heat of Texas, or sometimes those cold, cold mornings that we get. This trailer has a built-in water supply tank. It's actually built into the subframe. And the whole underbelly of this trailer is completely sealed off. It's a wonderful thing. Beneath that, we have the regular domestic, what we might call domestic water supply. Just connect your water pipe on there, and it's just like being in a house. As we go along a little further, we find here the utility shower. This is hot and cold running water. You know, you can wash off the dog, clean the fish, or whatever you want to do out here. And very important, because I'm a full-time RVer, this is the black tank water flusher. So after you've dumped your tanks, you can connect a water pipe on this and flush out that tank completely. So you're not going to take any nasty little residues home with you. Let's wander down to the slide here. Before we actually get to the slide, this is the refrigerator housing. Inside here, any maintenance that needs to be done on a fridge can be done from the outside. So there's absolutely no reason to remove a refrigerator. It makes life very, very simple. On the slide rooms, as you can see, we have rubber water guards and rubber seals. These are actually fixed into a framework so that they don't fall off. The slides are fully insulated. 2-inch walls with aluminum frame, just like the rest of the trailer. So you're not gonna have any heat coming in or out through the sidewalls here. The windows are all black, but only from the outside. On the inside, they're clear and you can see very well. So you have privacy, and it also stops the sun's rays coming through to get onto your furniture. Let's go around to the back now. This is the back end of the trailer. You can see the two windows here. I'll explain why there's two windows when we get inside. Here is a very important feature. This is your satellite and cable TV connections. It comes with a spare tire mounted on this solid steel bumper. Inside this little hatchway here, there's a cable. It's 25 feet long and it's your 30 amp shore power. So when you plug this in and you plug your water in, it's just like being in a little house. Very convenient. It tucks away, out of the way, et voila. Here is a rather strange looking contraption, and unfortunately I didn't set it up completely for you, but what this is a grill plate. There's a grill comes with this trailer. There's a gas connection here which runs off your two main bottles. The main grill hooks on here, and it's ideal for those sausages, chops, and anything else you may want to cook along the road. Slide around the corner again. Here we find another slide that was opposing the one that we just looked at. So if you can use your imagination a little, you can imagine how large this trailer is on the inside. But it's still very lightweight because of the aluminum and fiberglass. Let's wander along a little further. I'd like you to take special note of the wheels and the axles. As you can see, the axles are spread. With lightweight trailers, it's important to get a good balance. So we've spread the axles. This reduces the tongue weight. and also stops any swing or sway in the trailer. When the wheels are tied together, this won't happen, but by spreading them, it's beautiful. We have radial tires on chrome base wheels. This is your water heater. It's gas and electric. It's self-igniting. You don't have to come out here with a match in a wind and try and light it. Not a pleasant job. I've done it in the old days. The main door here has a help along handle. You don't need that until you get very old like me. And you have a three-step fold away system for when you're traveling. Very simple, very basic, but of course it works and it's not complicated. Let's go on inside now. This is really a remarkable trailer because we have two slides in the living area. A regular slide here with two armchairs and a super slide on the other side. This not only gives you an extraordinary amount of living room, but of course it does accommodate other people for sleeping on the sofa and in the dinette. The chairs are extremely comfortable. They rock and roll a little bit. You have lights above them. Something very important, I'd like you to show these blinds here, because these blinds not only obviously give you privacy, but if the sun's beating down on this side, this stops any heat coming in or stops any warmth going out should it be winter. So there's no need for those double glazed, extremely heavy, very expensive windows that we see touted around. These blinds do just the same sort of job. The slide room, as you can see, this is a mini, well not a mini slide, but an average slide with the two armchairs in it. There's no shortage of storage, once again. Everywhere you look in these trailers, every available piece of space is there for you for storage. We come to the television, and because this is a double angle trailer, the TV itself will turn and twist at any angle, go in, go out, and all sorts of weird and wonderful things. The radio has a CD player built into it. There's many of these electronics, because I'm very old, I don't really understand, but I understand you can plug all sorts of things in there for the kids. The sofa becomes another bed. It in itself is very comfortable. Daisy May, come on up here. Daisy May has lived in RVs virtually since she was born. She's very RV friendly. I think most RVers seem to have a dog. So she's very comfortable regardless of which one we go into. Right above me here, I'm going to do my little strength thing. These cabinets are actually built into the walls and to the ceiling. I only weigh a light 174 pounds, but I want to show you something about strength of these trailers. Don't do that with some of the opposition trailers, because you may end up with a load of cabinets down on your head. You'll certainly frighten the salesman. Let's go around to the dinette. The dinette is a six-seater instead of the average four. It makes up into a bed that's over 6.5 feet long. Now, with all the children around here, you expect them to spill stuff. The cushions, as you can see, are plasticized on one side for easy wipe down. Material one side, kiddie side. You know, being a full-time RVer as I am, one of the complaints I hear from many people is the lack of kitchen space. We don't have that problem with this trailer at all. We've got adequate storage underneath here, and as we actually move around into the kitchen itself, you can see we have an enormous amount of work surface. Very, very large work surface. A good size sink, built-in cutting boards because they're covers. For the ladies who like to cook spaghetti in the big pot, we have this very tall faucet. Hot and cold running water at hand, and a double sink with, of course, the good blockers. Let me just put the tops back on, and we'll move along to the stove. The stove is a three burner, but this front burner is very important. It's a high output burner, it will burn at high altitude. Underneath it is a 22-inch oven. A lot of trailers will only have 18s or 20s. This is a full 22-inch oven, so you can cook a small Thanksgiving bird. Above that, we have the hood with a light and fan. That's vented directly outside. For the frozen meals you prepare at home, in the freezer, pop them in here. Instant gratification for the kids. Where's the pantry? Well, how much pantry do you need? Full depth, as far as my arm and elbow will go in there. Please notice the woodwork, nice joints, no staples, nicely put together. Another set of cabinets above here, once again the same full depth. And underneath, wow, even more. We are certainly not short of storage. I'm going to switch to this side of the kitchen now because, once again, storage, that all important factor. We talk about depth. There's my arm, all the way in, fingers extended. That is a huge amount of storage. Plenty of cornflakes. The refrigerator and freezer. Works off propane and electricity. 8 cubic feet. Very simple. If you're traveling and you want to keep the fridge on, just turn it on to gas. It travels quite safely. Simple to operate. Mode, temperature, gas or electric. Close the door. Refrigeration. Wonderful. Let's head for the bathroom. In the bathroom now, good size medicine cabinet. Keep all the little scratchy things the kids are sure to need when you're out playing around in the woods. Small sink, but very useful. And a double plug in here for Dad's electric razor, Mum's hair dryer. Down below, small storage cabinet. But the most important thing with this guy here is the size of this shower. It's a full dad size shower. I'm a little over 6 feet tall. And as you can see, a 7.5 foot dad can get in there and get a good shower. And little kids as well. And of course, the inevitable potty. It's a marine potty. The controls on the floor, very simple. Water comes in, other stuff goes out. And above it, the all-important powered fan. Obviously, to just get rid of the steam from the shower. Let's move on to the bedroom, shall we? And here we are in the main bedroom. Of course, when you go to bed, you might want to take a TV with you. There's hookups here and a place of one wall mountings here that a small flat screen TV can be fitted. As you can see, the bed is nice and comfortable. Daisy Mae's made herself at home. Of course, she always does. This is the most well-traveled dog you've ever met. She's actually been right down into Central America with me on one of my many walkabouts, which I'll tell you about when you get in here. Nice big shirt closets, nice and deep. Go all the way in, overhead up here. Overheads, overheads and overheads. Once again, you can see there's some depth in them, some nice glass frontage. Above us here, a light. There's also a light in the center here for your reading. The air conditioning is ducted all the way through here. The whole coach is ducted air conditioning. There's a 13.5 air conditioner in here. The roof is very heavily insulated, as is the floor. The floor actually has 3 layers. It's very, very well built. We have a control system here. And one of the things, especially when you've got kiddies with you, is to make sure they're not running slides out and what have you. This is a daddy-only cabinet. Up here we have controls for the slide rooms. We have controls for the other slide room, the powered awning, the gas and electric gas, the water heater. And up here, this tells you a monitor gauge for all your grey water, black water, fresh water, and battery condition, and the auxiliary water pump is built right on here. It's very easy to contact us, folks. We have an 800 phone number. The number is 1-800-983-7866. I'm cheating here because although I've worked here for over 11 years, on my phone I just press the word work and it phones me. But also, of course, we're on the internet, hwhrv.com, hwhrv.com. And of course, every piece of information you could possibly need is right on there. For myself, Croc Marshall, my little friend and constant companion Daisy Mae. We look forward to seeing you. Wish you safe and happy journeys. Au revoir, Buen Horizon, and all those other things in strange languages that I'm supposed to be able to speak. Just have a good time. Come and see us. From Daisy and myself, God bless, safe journeys. Bye for now.